Alright, you may think this looks like the normal curve because it's close, but it's a little bit off, and we'll talk about that later because of successes. You can't count a success. What's the term? There's a term that describes it's like fluency between successes or failures, and so the binomial distribution is a little bit off because of that, and there's some correlation continuing. I can't remember the word, but I'll tell you in a minute. So we want to look at this distribution, and let me tell you what the standard deviation of this is. It is the square root, which looks like, let me get a different color. Let's get this blue. It is a square root. This is the standard deviation symbol, looks like this. That equals, let me type this. In, make it some difference. Is N times P times 1 minus P. And so that would be, for this, let me get the calculator, and let's do NP times 1 minus P would be 50 times 0.5 times 0.5 equals 12.5, and the square root of that. So here's what we just did. We just did the SQR, square root of, let me use a big bracket, so the square root of this 50 times P times 1 minus P. Well, I guess I don't need to do that again. I can just go 0.5 times 0.5, and that is a SQR, square root of 12.5, which is, whoops, not enough room. And we don't need that much detail. So the standard deviation of this would be 3.5. So let's draw the mean there. And so it would be 3.5 and plus 3.5. So so 20, you change back to that yellow. Nope. Text. V. One standard deviation above the mean would be 28.5. And then that same, with that same logic, one standard deviation below would be 21.5. And wrong color again. Still the wrong color. So this would be 7 of that. This would be 32. And this would be 18. I don't like these ones in this font. It looks like a capital I. I'm going to change that. At any rate, one standard deviation above, two standard deviations above, one below, two below.